Hi everyone, I'm Lennox. Today I'm gonna talk and explain a little bit about levator scapulae syndrome. So first of all, I have to show you what is the levator scapular muscle and where is, and then we are gonna talk a little bit what is the cause and the signs and symptoms of this syndrome. Okay, so we can see here the muscle, the levator of scapulae, is part of the muscle of the upper back muscles and shoulder muscles as well. So we can see here the levator of scapulae. You know, we can see the origin is here in the cervical vertebrae, and the insertion is here in the superior angle of the scapula medial side. So it's very important here, the insertion, because here in this area is when the person is gonna, you know, feel more the pain or when the syndrome starts, okay? Very good. So we can see here the origin, the insertion. So the origin is the transverse process of the first four cervical vertebrae. And the insertion is in the superior angle of the scapula medial side, okay? Very good. And levator of scapulae, the name, you know, say what is the action, is the elevation of the scapula, like that. Okay, very good. So, what is the syndrome or what happened with this muscle? So, some people, for example, do a lot of movement, repetitive movement, especially swimmers, okay, or people who have to be sitting for longer time or working like that in this position, you know, like the shoulders is gonna, you know, anteriorly or like that. So it's gonna cause overstretch of the muscles of the back. So when the muscle is very stretched and stretched and stretched, it's gonna cause a stress on the muscle. So a lot of stretch causes as well a stress. So the fibers, of the muscle get irritated. So pain starts, you know. So as well, for example, in women, when we use the bra and it's all the time, it's very tight, the bra at and the back as well, because not only is when it's overstretched, not the extremes, all the extremes are bad. When it's overstretched or when it's a lot all the time, you know, like tight the muscle as well, trigger the pain. Okay, very good. So what happened here? So it's where, for example, sometimes when the person complained that can move, for example, the neck. So any movement that person wanna do it is gonna feel pain. So a stiffness of the neck is one of the signs and symptoms, because you can move the neck because it's very painful. You see, you're gonna feel here the pain. As well, when you touch this point, it's gonna feel pain as well. Sometimes when it's very acute, you can see the area swollen, warm a little bit. If maybe the syndrome is caused for any kind of accident, so we can see as well a little bit bruise. So it depends what is the cause. Okay, very good. So some of the causes, you know, more specific, could be any kind of dysfunction in the cervical vertebrae. So of course it's gonna cause problem in the muscle, because remember the origin is here. So any dysfunction here can cause the problem in the muscle. As well, the bad posture. So when person have, you know, poor posture and all the time are like that, the shoulders are rounded, can, you know, trigger the pain. As well, repetitive movements, for example, like a swimmers. So when they do these movements, can cause as well problem in the levator scapulae. Carrying bags, for example, when we, especially for example in women, that sometimes we like to carry our purse here in just in one shoulder and we never change, you know, and it's very heavy, so trigger the pain or trigger the syndrome right away. As well, you know, if you have, for example, carrying bags here very heavy all the time, too many hours, as well, it's gonna cause the pain. Okay? And of course, stress or anxiety. People who suffer for stress is under too much, you know, stress because any kind of problem or another disease, another sickness can trigger as well the problem in this area. So this is why sometimes when you feel that you are stressed or you, for example, go to sleep and during the day you was, you know, you have a lot of problems in your job, in your home, whatever, and the next day when you wake up you can move the neck and you, oh my God, it's really painful here. So this is the Leber scapular syndrome. So it's called syndrome when it's, you know, repetitive and for longer time, okay? So signs and symptoms, I mentioned some when I start talking about, so it's neck pain. Headache can cause headache, of course, because you know, neck pain, headache. Stiffness can move, stiffness in the neck, can move stiffness in the shoulder, because if you move, pain is coming. So, especially, you know, with, for example, I'm talking about the neck, cervical flexion or side flexion or rotations is gonna be painful, okay? So, as well, deep achy pain, you know, in this area, when you touch here, the area where is the attachment of the muscle is gonna feel pain as well. And of course, the muscle tone is gonna increase. So when you touch here, this area is hard, you know, the muscle tone is increased. And when you can find as well the trigger point, you know, because a lot of stress trigger point, so is people is gonna show you or is gonna report not just pain here, you know, in the area, is gonna report pain that is going, you know, through the neck, or is going as well through the arm, all the arm, and is going as well all, you know, all the back. So this is when the trigger point in the levator scapulae, you know, is triggered. So, cause this kind of pain. We can see here, for example, this is the, when the person, the trigger point, you see, all that is in red is when the person is gonna report that feeling pain. Sometimes the pain is no, sometimes you touch here the area and the person say, no, I don't feel the pain here. I feel the pain, you know, the neck, here, here. Is a trigger point, okay? And it's coming from the levator of scapulae muscle. How to treat that? So first of all, we have to see what is the cause, because we can maybe go for massage, go for physio, we can do massage, self-massage at home, apply cold, apply hot compress, whatever, and you are gonna treat the signs and symptoms, but you are not gonna treat the cause. If you don't treat the cause, the problem is still coming and goes, you know, or it's all the time here, you know, and it's very painful, it's very uncomfortable. So first of all, you have to find what is the cause. It is poor posture, so we are gonna correct the posture. How we're gonna correct the posture? We need to stretch the pectoralis, we need as well strengthen muscles of the back, you know, because if these muscles are like that, these muscles need to be stretched, back muscles need to be strengthened. So correct the posture. It is caused because of the stress, so you have to handle the stress to see what is happening in your life. It is caused because the bags, you know, carry heavy bags, so you have to change the shoulder, you know, or maybe you have to see if you don't carry heavy bags, maybe use something that you can use your hand, you know, and nothing here. It is in women and the bra is very tight, so you can too, you have to see that a little bit loose. So for example, when you are at home, don't use the bra because you need to feel, you know, free. The muscles have to feel free. So first of all, we need to see what is the cause. It is for repetitive movement like a swimmer, so just rest, you know, and see, you know, maybe the biomechanic that you are using in your body when you are swimming. Maybe you are using, you know, wrong biomechanic, or you are pushing so hard your body. So you know. When we see what is the cause, we can go to treat the area. So doing massage, apply cold or hot compress, depends if it's acute or not acute, working in the fascia, working with massage, working with stretching, working with electrotherapy, ultrasound, acupuncture is really good as well, acupressure is really well, is really good as well. So many things that we can, you know, use. Self-massage at home as well is really good. For example, when you grab here the muscle, squeeze and just move and stretch the head and the neck in all the ways, is gonna release as well. Using the tennis ball, you know, the pressure. So you can, you know, treat this problem. So it depends, but depends. First of all, you have to see the cause and then, you know. One treatment that you can do at home, I told you, use the tennis ball. Apply here the tennis ball, go through your back, self-massage, you know, against the table, the bed, against the wall, you know. When you feel that the pain is a little bit, you know, go releasing, you can push a little bit more hard, no more than 2 minutes. Self-stretching as well is really important. Muscle squishing, fascia as well, and it is no acute, just you can apply hot compresses, or it is very acute, cold compress, so you can see. But first of all, you have to see what is the cause. So I hope so. This information help you, you know, with this problem, and I hope so, you know, try to avoid the causes so you are not gonna suffer of this syndrome. Thank you very much.